السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, everyone out there. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I pray you're well and preparing for your best Ramadan ever, inshallah ta'ala. This is one year Ramadan will not catch us off guard, بإذن الله. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you in your preparations and to bless you and your loved ones in these coming days, spiritually and mentally and emotionally and physically and everything in between. Just, I'll keep it extra short this evening, but something that I've been thinking about since the beginning of this crisis, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ, and remind the people about the days of God. What are the days of God? Because all days belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even the greatest day of all, the day of judgment. But the days of God are the days when God became most manifest in our dunya, in our worldly lives, when the power of Allah and the control of Allah and the retribution of Allah, like for example, the day of the flood of Moses. This is an obvious day of God, the days of the destruction of the perished nations. But this does not discount or dismiss the fact that any day when God's almightiness becomes crystal clear and extra evident, that it could be a day of God. And that is why we would not be venturing very far to say that we are living in a unique historical moment, that we should understand what we're living, so that we can live that moment properly. I mean, subhanallah al-azim, how great is Allah that He ended the debates and He silenced the arguments with an event, not with a statement. And He exposed our collective arrogance as the modern world, and our demand for an explanation of God, or our demands that God's demands be reduced to an hour a week, or all of these ills of prosperity. Allah Azza wa Jal has shown us just how exposed, just how vulnerable, just how transgressive we are, and we can be, and we continue to be, the moment we forget Him. As He said elsewhere in the Quran, كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Certainly the human being will always transgress when he feels himself self-sufficient, like he has no needs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us that at the height of our advancement, at the height of modernity, we are as needy and as vulnerable and as powerless as ever. And so we must be very careful about this moment that we are living, that many people in the modern era died before they saw. This is a huge deal. And what comes after this moment and this glaring reminder will also be critical. Because Allah Azza wa Jal said, you know, in the verse where I mentioned to you a week ago, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why is it that when our punishment came to them, they didn't show their brokenness? Do you know what the very next verse says? The very next verse says, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ. But then after that, their hearts were hard. And then when they forgot the reminder, yet again, even after the punishment, they forgot the reminder that they were reminded with. What does Allah say? What is the punishment? فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبْوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. We opened up for them, we expanded for them the gates of everything. After they forgot the reminder, you think it's going to say we annihilated them. It says we opened the floodgates of prosperity for them. And then when they completely forgot what they were here for, forgot their purpose, forgot their mission, forgot their origin and their destination, we took them suddenly. فَرِحُوا بِمَا أُوتُوا. And once they rejoiced with the return of prosperity or with the increased prosperity, we snatched them suddenly. And so we need to be extremely careful about getting used to the lockdown and just saying, okay, alhamdulillah, not too bad, it's all right here. We got this under control of, you know, a few more days, a few more weeks, and things will be back to normal. That is an extremely dangerous mindset to have, because back to normal or what we call normal, is the exact thing that Allah shattered for us using this corona lockdown. Normal was not a good place. You know, the discussion on proving God's existence, the discussion to some extent, not entirely, but to some extent even gender, these are signs of entitlement, signs of privilege. In crises, no one talks about these things. No one speaks about atheism. No one speaks about, you know, like just arbitrary gender reassignment or fluidity. And these things are superfluous is the word, right? They are extra. They are when you feel like you're in full control and you have everything in your hands. You begin to slip into this ugly, arrogant state of playing God. And that is what we need to immunize ourselves from. And that has to happen before Corona ends. Like, what aggressive changes will I make in my life to further and advance myself as the subject of God, as the subservient, submissive, devout servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is not just some dua we're going to make. It is not just some wait time and it's a quick fix, a life hack like everything else in our life. No, our life has a grand purpose and Allah has chosen us and esteemed us if we are to realize that. And if not, then we will plummet beneath even the animals and we will be subjected to a punishment the likes of which many nations have never seen. So may Allah Azza wa Jal help us wake up more and more with every brand new day. Remove the dust off of us, you know, rub off of this rust. Get past the fact that yes, we are being arrogant. Yes, we are taking things too lightly. Yes, we are at a juncture, a crossroads, whether we're going to get closer to Allah or we can potentially be sealed off, may Allah forbid, at a point of seemingly no return. May Allah help us and you and make us worthy to be His slaves. Allahumma ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.